Donald and Douglas are twin engines, and both work hard on the Little Western main line. No matter what the job, whether it be coaches or trucks, they both finish their jobs with a smile. One morning, the fat controller had come to the twin engine's shed.
Hey, good afternoon, sir.
What could you need done?
Henry has been called in for routine maintenance and won't be back for a while. Gordon and James are already covering his goods and passengers, so I need for you two to take the flying Kipper for him. Do you think that you two could handle the job?
Hey, you can count on us.
As the fat controller left for Burger King, Douglas's face fell.
Do you think we bit off a bit more than we could chew, Donny?
Ugh, like a little fish train could do any harm.
But Douglas still had second thoughts. It was early when their drivers and firemen arrived.
I thought you wanted to take this train, Donny.
Ugh, would you give me a minute? I'm still just waking up.
Douglas only sighed and left for the harbor. As Douglas was being coupled up, Donald finally arrived.
A bad time you shouldn't wheel, you wee rusty sack of all.
Hey, my crew were having hell with building my damn fire. And didn't call me a rusty Shackleford. Remember last week's incident?
Aye. Just shut your trap and get coupled in front.
And with that, Donald coupled in front of Douglas. They waited forever for the guard's whistle. And soon, we're off with the Kipper.
Ugh, it's about bloody time.
Thank you.
They were making good time and running nicely. Just then, they arrived at Edward's station and had to wait for the banker.
Like we need help from a banker. We could run this hill, no trouble.
The last time we chanced it, you nearly had to make an emergency trip to the works. There's no way in hell we can make it up here, especially with the Kipper.
Donald grumbled as the banking engine had buffered up behind the train. But they didn't reckon without James. Every morning, James has to take a building supply train bound for whichever station it needs it most. Today, it had been set for the new mainline loop. But the signalman sent James on the wrong line, and James had to stop at Kildane, and was waiting for the twins to pass. What happened next, no one knows. Both Donald Douglas and James's crew all blame the signalman. The signalman says that James was in the way of the Kipper. Anyway, Donald and Douglas were speeding past the ice cream factory at a tremendous rate, and...
Hey,
Douglas. Donald!
Ugh, what's happened?
You and Douglas crashed into the back of James's maintenance train. Are you both all right?
Ugh, I feel terrible.
I think one of my wheels clocked out of place.
Soon, Donald and Douglas were brought back on the rails, and soon, they were taken to the fitter's yard, where Henry had finished being repaired and was steaming nicely. When he saw them in the state they were in, he was reminded of his own accident with the Kipper, and gave James a knowing look. James could only silently agree. Soon, Henry was called away to take the express. While Donald and Douglas spent a long time in the works, and soon the engines on the Little Western would feel the strain. But that's another story.